Philippine Shares joined a global rout amid growing concern over the COVID-19 outbreak, with a number of cases outside China surging. Technical analyst Bonner Detok recalls Philippine equities had been at the tail end of a bear market when the SARS outbreak hit in 2002 and 2003. He adds, technical charts show a bear market has been a long time coming.
Right now, what it needs to do is to break above 7.6 for it to be considered a bit bullish, but it has to sustain that. With the unfortunately, you do have the three moving averages blocking its way, and that might be a problem. There are some small chances for a small gain, but it might not be worth the effort. It's too hard. The chances of you losing money in this kind of a market is much bigger.
For the day, the PSE index shed 2.5% or 182 points, its biggest one-day drop since January 31, to close at 71.87. Eagle Equities' Joey Rojas says another issue weighing down on the market is the uncertainty over Philippine offshore gaming operators, or POGOs, amid reports China is stepping up its crackdown on the industry.
I would think it's more of the POGO issue, what came out over the weekend regarding the Chinese government's cancellation of their citizens' passports on the suspicion that they are working in POGOs in the Philippines. We sold down a lot of the real estate issues, around 3%, I think, average. I think the biggest was FLI, which is down 4%.
In corporate stories, Meralco posts flat earnings for the full year of 2019 as a drop in non-electricity revenue partially offset growth in electricity revenue. The power distributor says Philippine offshore gaming operators and steady contribution of BPO sector boosted its growing customer base outside Metro Manila. Also helping boost electricity sales, government's Build, Build, Build program. ABS-CBN shares outperformed their peers, popping 17% as the Senate conducted a hearing on its franchise. Now, it also filed today its comment on the petition for quo warranto filed by the Office of the Solicitor General.
This has been falling since the high of around 68, way back in 2016. So right now, what it's doing is just less than a third of that value. But it recently was able to try and retest the 22 peso level, which is now proving to be a resistance for it. Since March of last year, I see ABS going sideways as to what it's trying to do. It's not yet too clear, but giving us a bullish divergence, so there could be something good for it in the future.
Michelle Long, ABS-CBN News.